Stay with Gemma as she gets the latest from the UAE's biggest influencers.
Well, hello there. I am super excited to welcome the fabulous Tala Saman. She's in the studio. She is author of the blog My Fash Diary. Welcome.
Hi, Gemma.
How are you doing today?
Good. How are you?
Wonderful. So it's awesome to have you here for International Happiness Day as well. You couldn't make my day any better. So let's start with the fact that you are one of the UAE's leading bloggers. The first to launch in the Gulf, actually.
Yeah, the first to launch in the UAE.
And how, tell us, let's start with a bit about yourself and your obvious interest in fashion.
So I basically started myfashdiary.com, which is my blog, over 9 years ago. And I was a student at the London College of Fashion. I actually grew up here in Dubai, and it started off as purely just a little fashion blog. Wasn't making anything out of it. Like I was posting 3 times a day, daily, 7 days a week. And I mean, now it's been like 9 years. Now it's a lifestyle site, so it's broken down into 4 categories. So it's fashion, beauty, travel, and food.
And you said you started off just doing it kind of like a hobby.
Yeah.
So what was the next step, that the catalyst that broke you into saying, no, this is, I want to make this a priority. I want to make it a big deal.
To be honest, I think once you realize people are actually reading what you're writing, it just causes pressure. And I think, you know, I was lucky. I started off quite early, and I did kind of garner a really loyal base of a loyal following. I feel like I kind of grew up with my readers. So I started off, it was purely just fashion. And then now it's kind of whatever kind of gets me curious about things, I end up writing about.
So as a pro in the blogging sphere, share with us what sort of commitment it takes to maintain a blog. And your blog has over 200,000 viewers per month. That is a massive figure.
Yeah. To be honest, I think a lot of people don't realize that the time that goes into things, because nowadays I think the word influencer is thrown around quite a bit, and you can kind of be an influencer doing anything. But with a blog, it's the time that goes behind it and the consistency, because that's the thing. Once you stop that consistency, you lose a following. Because people want to know when to go back. And
so what, could you break it down to us? What is your schedule to keep this blog pumping?
I mean, I don't have a schedule, but I nowadays it's more whatever kind of excites me, I end up writing about. But obviously I need to keep content coming in quite a bit. So I do try to update the site 5 days a week. Not as often now because I DJ as well on the side, but I try to keep, it's like quality over quantity nowadays. And
So 5 days a week, it's kind of like a job.
Yeah, it is.
That's done. Today is done. And since it first hit off in 2009, have you changed your angle a bit? Are you a little bit experimental in the content, or you fixed with a tried and tested method?
You know what? When I first started, I think I wanted to write things that would interest my readers. Whereas now I just think if it excites me, the people that have been following my blog for 9 years, it's going to excite them as well. I think I was always just like hearing what people wanted to read about and write that and talk about that. Whereas now, but I think I've matured a lot more as well. Like, you know, I was 18 when I first started.
Oh my gosh. So it's a little bit like a time machine for you when you go back to the early days.
Yeah, I was a baby.
And I bet you've got such loyal followers. They're loving it. They're seeing you grow as a person, but even your story unfold.
Yeah, no, it's amazing when I meet, because I sometimes do events with brands, and I get to meet girls that actually grew up with my blog. Like it's crazy. It's amazing. And I think that's what motivates you, because it does get, like, a lot of the time, like if you're traveling and you're going on a break, it's easy to just kind of neglect the site and not update. But like you can't really do that, and that's the commitment you take when you start, you know, when you're a content creator and you have a blog.
I bet. Especially, as you said, your followers, they feel a part of your life. So if you go off the grid, they're thinking, Tala, what's the latest?
Yeah, and I mean, you could lose your following just by like not updating. If you're a person that updates a site 3 times a week, for example, or 5 times a week, and just like go off for 3 weeks, you will,
So you've got to be very disciplined about
definitely, yeah.
Keep it constant. Yeah. Yes, we are back. It's Gemma here with The Vibe. I am joined by not only one of the UAE's biggest bloggers, but around the world, Miss Tala Saman, the author of My Fash Diary. Thank you.
Hi.
So let's continue where we just momentarily put a pause button on. Now, My Fash Diary, it's a big deal, but in this digital era, there's a tough competition with new content, budding influences popping up left, right, and center. How tough is it in the blogging world to stand out and keep your high profile?
To be honest, it is a very, it's an oversaturated market. It's crazy. When I first started 9 years ago, I think we were around 5 bloggers for the first 4 years. Yeah, like 5 key bloggers.
So that's a nice head start.
Yeah, and actually not many of them are still blogging. I mean, all of them have gone to like bigger things. Huda's gone to like running her beauty. Yeah.
Yes. Yep.
and I guess a lot of people have started their own brands. And I've still kept my site just because for me, content creation is something I really enjoy. And but I guess when you're talking about like the market generally, I feel like a lot of them don't actually have blogs. So I guess that's one thing that I always felt like I kind of stood out from. Like I produce content. I think nowadays a lot of people
are regurgitating content, whereas yours is all original.
Like, yeah. And I also write content. Like I don't just, you know, post a, not to hate on anyone, but I don't post a picture and a caption and consider that content. But
okay. So how much research or preparation do you do before you upload something?
To be honest, sometimes I would be back and forth on one post for like 4 months.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
Oh,
and
gosh.
And I do a lot of guides. So like I'll do travel guides. So I prep that in advance. I travel. I do my research. I actually try out things. So whenever I travel, like if I'm in LA for 2 weeks, I'll do an LA guide on like where to get a blowout, where to work out, where to eat, where to, yeah.
Also. So yes, sticking to your topics, fashion, food, travel.
Yeah.
But as you say, loads of preparation involved with each post.
Because with my site, I like people to kind of go back, and I hear that a lot from women. And I guess that's another thing. I target a large range of women with the posts. So with fashion, beauty, I feel like I target a much younger market than I do for instance, for food and travel. And what's nice is a lot of, whenever I hear women say that they actually go back to features I wrote about, you know, 6-8 months before.
So it certainly makes all that time worth it.
Yeah,
then.
Yeah.
You're putting up some very valuable content.
Exactly. Just content that people can kind of go back to and pick up things from, learn something from, because I learn a lot from, you know, from the research that goes behind it.
So it's not surprising then that you've been nominated for many blog awards. Do you care to share some of those with us?
I mean, I've won a few like in the past. Nowadays, I feel like there's so many awards. Did win a Grazia Style Award and like the Stylist Magazine Awards. And when I lived in London, I won a Marie Claire Blog and Twitter Award.
That must be so exciting and really just make you...
You know, that's what keeps you... You were asking me what keeps me motivated, but like that's, I guess, like when you meet people that enjoy your content and when you see people appreciate things that you, you know, you put time into, that definitely keeps me motivated.
Now, can you tease with us? What can we expect for the future of My Fash Diary?
Honestly, I'm trying to infuse more music into it. So that's... I've always loved music. And I always never felt like it was the right fit to throw music into the site. Slowly doing that. And what's nice is, I guess, like music speaks to everyone. So there is room for that. But just finding the right fit for that.
I can imagine. And for the fact that you first launched the blog in 2009, of course, it's going to evolve. So now you're saying you want to dabble into a music aspect,
yeah,
as well.
Yeah.
super.
And I feel like it works well with lifestyle, right?
Definitely, of course. Music is live.
Yeah.
We live life loud here at Dance FM. No, it's awesome. So are you doing some music gigs on the side? What sort of music are we talking about?
To be honest, when I first started DJing, I honestly just would do it for fun. It was like a hobby over 3 years ago. I think it was 4 years when I first started. Initially just like dabbled on vinyl, and then just would enjoy. I would record. I have a SoundCloud page, and then slowly started getting, because I'd work with fashion and beauty brands, started spinning for their events. I recently opened up for Dua Lipa when she was here in the UAE, in Abu Dhabi.
Wow. So heaps of opportunities have opened up.
Yeah.
Tala, it has been a pleasure. Thank you so much for joining us here on The Vibe for Beats and Bloggers. You can check out the full interview with Tala, aka My Fash Diary. Jump onto dancefm.com. Loads more to come on the show. A-Lock next. And let's hit on with this high contrast remix, Alyssa and Jonas Blue, Hearts Ain't Gonna Lie. It's not what you say.